Can I make a spooky beating heart candy bowl for Halloween?
I used an inexpensive candy bowl, some acrylic, a hot glue gun, an MP3 player with an extension cable and a splitter, a set of powered speakers, an Arduino Uno and a breadboard, some LEDs, resistors, a capacitor, and a 3.5 millimeter audio input, a few bits of scrap wood. I made a shelf for the candy to sit on and the electronics to sit under. I didn't want a hole in the shelf, so I found a kitchen lid that was about the right size, traced it, and cut the acrylic with a jigsaw. It cracked. More tries resulted in more cracks. I drilled a hole in the center of the circle and inserted a small nail. I measured the 5-inch radius and made a mark in one area. I used a string to roughly mark the circle area so I could cut away the excess in advance. I cut away material to the exact 5-inch mark. I attached the acrylic to some hardboard, positioned the blade where I cut away, and clamped the hardboard to the bandsaw table. I rotated the acrylic carefully to cut a good circle. It fitted about the depth I was intending, but too much pressure on the edge could cause it to fall into the bowl and disturb the electronics. I marked where the shelf sat in the bowl, cut 3 pieces of scrap wood for supports. This seemed to work as intended, so I painted them black and hot glued them to the sides of the bowl. Then I drilled a hole for the speaker wire. I removed the protective film from the acrylic and used some sandpaper to frost it. The Arduino can only detect positive voltages in its analog inputs. The audio signal will run between positive and negative voltages. To handle this, I set up a voltage divider using 2 equal resistors connected in series from the Arduino 5-volt connection and ground. The voltage value in between the resistors is 2.5 volts, as described by Ohm's law. Now the audio input is applied at the point between the resistors through a capacitor. I'm not sure how this works, but this varies the 2.5 voltage at that point. Can someone explain to me how this works? This is where we connect the analog input A0 of the Arduino. The Arduino uses a digital output system where it puts out values of plus 5 volts and 0 volts. It will turn the signal on and off at a given frequency that will give the appearance of different brightnesses in the LED. This is called pulse width modulation. Now be careful, not all the pins on the Arduino support it. I placed the 2 LEDs on digital output 3, adding a resistor in series to keep the proper voltages across the LEDs. The Arduino sketch handles converting the analog signal to the frequency for LED pulsing. A quick test without sound had each LED showing up as a distinct point on the shelf, which spoils the illusion. After coming up with various complicated ways to diffuse the light, I discovered that a single piece of masking tape across the 2 LEDs gave the effect I wanted very simply. I placed a heartbeat soundtrack on the MP3 player and set it to repeat. I put a splitter into the output and connected one end to the audio input and the other end to the speakers. I powered the Arduino with a 9-volt battery.
I hope the younger kids will find it spooky and not too scary. I'm sure the teenagers with no costumes and a pillowcase won't be impressed. This is my first trip into the world of Arduino and electronics. Please let me know in the comments if there are better ways for me to accomplish this. The Arduino sketch and the wiring diagram are available in a link in the description. You can join an exclusive club by liking my Facebook page and following me on Twitter. If you enjoy this video, please like it and share it with your friends. If you didn't enjoy this video, please share it like that videotape in the movie The Ring.